Welcome to a lesson on how to use the intersection feature of the TI84 graphing calculator to find all of the real rational zeros or roots of a polynomial function. Normally when using the TI84 graphing calculator to find the real rational zeros, we're told to use the zeros feature, but using the intersection method is actually much easier. So to review, we're trying to find the real rational values of x that make this function equal to zero. And when we talk about function values, we're talking about y values. So we're looking for the values of x where y is equal to zero. Graphically, these would be the x-intercepts. But again, instead of using the zero feature, we want to use the intersection method. To do this, we can graph y equals our polynomial function, and then also graph y equals zero, which is the equation for the x-axis. But then we can use the intersection method to find which x values make the function equal to zero. So from the home screen, we'll press y equals, clear out any old functions. We'll type in our polynomial function in y1. So we have x to the third, here's the exponent key, minus 3x squared. For the exponent of 2, we can press x squared here, minus 13x plus 15. We'll press enter, and then for y2 we'll enter 0. We're not going to see this second graph because it's going to be the x-axis, but it does allow us to use the intersection feature rather than the zero feature. So now let's press zoom 6 so that we have the standard window. Again, there's our polynomial function, and again it's graphing y equals 0 now, but we can't see it because it's actually the x-axis. And now to find the x-intercepts, or which x values make the function equal to zero, we can press second trace and then use option 5. Now the reason this is helpful is, if we press 5, we don't have to deal with the left bound, right bound issue that we do when using the zero feature. The only thing we have to do is move the cursor closest to the x-intercept that we're trying to find. Let's work our way from left to right, so I'm going to press the left arrow until I see the cursor close to the leftmost x-intercept. So that's very close. Now all I have to do is press enter 3 times. Enter, enter, enter. Notice how it's telling us when x equals negative 3, y is equal to 0. So negative 3 is a 0 of our function. Now let's go find the other two zeros. So again, we can just press second trace, option 5, move the cursor closer to this x-intercept in the middle, pressing the right arrow. That's close enough. Now we just press enter 3 times. Enter, enter, enter. So we can see this zero is x equals 1. So it avoids all of that confusion on dealing with the left bound and right bound, whether that means above or below the x-intercept. Now I did make a video using the zero feature, but I think you'll like this method better. And now for the last zero, again we're going to press second trace, option 5, press the right arrow until we're close to the rightmost x-intercept. If we're ever not sure where the cursor is, we can look right here and it tells us. That's close enough. We'll press enter 3 times. Enter, enter, enter. Our last zero is x equals 5. Now I also want to make the connection between having these zeros and finding the factors of our polynomial function. If x equals negative 3 is a zero of the function, then x plus 3 must be a factor of the function. Notice if we substitute negative 3 here, we have a factor of 0. If x equals positive 1 is a zero, then x minus 1 is a factor. And if x equals positive 5 is a zero, then x minus 5 is a factor. If we multiply these factors together, we would end up with the original polynomial function. Okay, but our main goal for this video was to find the real rational zeros, which we found here. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.